I was enchanted by going to the pictures. I loved the experiences, the thrills and the comedy, being taken into New York apartments and racing over the prairies with cowboys. I found that very interesting and exciting for me in a small country village.
When did you start being a protectionist? Where?
When I was 15.
Well, that's pretty rare.
For the first time in my life, there was something I was rather good at because I was passionate about it. Watching films and being paid for it, it was absolutely heaven.
Is this what we're going to see?
It is, yes. It's a rewinder to rewind the film from end out back
tons
to the beginning.
And tons.
Tons
are
there
and
any
tons more rooms of films.
Cans, lots of rooms of films. Yes.
Really?
Now, I met you in the Portobello, where we both had a stall.
Mm-hmm.
And your stall was mainly books, and you just had this little section of film stills.
Yes.
So that was your main interest, wasn't it, the cinema?
It was, yes. One of the operators I worked with used to go down to the local street market on a Friday, and he came back with some 10x8 glossy photographs from films. These were beautiful, sharp, clear pictures, which I'd never seen these press stills before. I was very envious of these and in the end managed somehow to get them from him by swapping or buying or something. And that was the beginning of collecting photographs connected with films.
How many pictures do you think you've got all together, roughly?
Well, it would be more than a million, I would say.
So what is that? Posters, stills?
Posters and photographs and portraits and illustrations of all kinds. We have lots of side peripheral elements, such as film history and reviews of films and all kinds of other things, the trade publications and so on. But I think the main thrust is going to the pictures, which was such a central thing to people's lives in the 20s, the 30s, the 40s and the 50s. The 60s and 70s were very bad and places were closing down. Every time they closed the cinema, they stripped everything out of it and put it in the store because it could be used in another of their cinemas. Tons of stuff, but no cinemas to use it in because the circuit was shrinking. I thought, I'll buy 100 and I'll pay £1 each for them, £100 for 100 seats. So these are from the Cinema House Aberdeen and cost £1 each. It came to a point where it looked like a really very, very interesting and comprehensive collection. Finding a home has been really, really difficult. Every single vacant library, school, anywhere that might be useful as a home to us was impossible to buy because there was always developers with big checkbooks ready. At one point, we were going to be evicted from here because the landlord, the National Health Service, wanted to sell it. Because of the property crash, we then had a reprieve, and now they wouldn't mind still selling it, and they have asked us if we would like to buy it, well, which we would, but we need time and security to be able to find some money, which is quite difficult in this time. It's the uncertainty that's the thing that's so demoralizing and draining of energy. But we're getting very close now.
Yes.
We're doing a fundraising campaign very soon, and we're hoping that we will be able to buy this building.
And then the dream will have come true. You'll have your cinema and museum.
Then I can fall off the perch.
Yes.
Happy. Close the lid, smiling.